Xcode 13 brought in a couple nice features, but there's one that got me particularly excited, the addition of Vim Keybinds. I totally assume myself, and in an attempt to convert you to this weird obsession, I'm making this short video to cover the basics to get you started with using Vim Keybinds within Xcode 13. This is not intended as a deep dive into every command you can use, and I'll even purposely try to avoid showing things that serve more or less the same function with varying degrees of precision, so it doesn't get too confusing. Just use this as a start point to build off of when learning Vim that hopefully won't be as daunting and confusing as opening a cheat sheet with 100 commands and trying to learn from that. Once you're hooked, you can hopefully go back to those cheat sheets and more easily adopt the more precise optimizations you can make while using Vim. Alright, so let's jump into it. If you haven't done so already, let's jump into Xcode and enable Vim Keybinds by going into Editor and checking Vim Mode. And just like that, you can't type anything anymore. That sounds a bit counterproductive, right? Don't worry, you just happen to be in what Vim calls normal mode, or the mode that allows you to use editor commands to move around, select, or copy and paste text. Most of what I'll show you today will be done inside this normal mode, and we'll get back to it in a minute. For now, let's figure out how we can actually write text and get back to coding. To do so, we'll have to enter a second mode, the fairly self-explanatory insert mode. To go from normal mode and enter insert mode, all we have to do is press the I key. You can notice that Xcode gives us a nice indicator showing us we are now successfully in insert mode. And now that we're in insert mode, we can type normally. Actually, most of the Xcode navigation, like using Option plus arrow keys for example, will work while in this mode. Once we're done typing what we needed, we can exit insert mode and go back to normal mode by using the escape key. Like I said, I don't want to dive too deep into every single command that can be used for small optimizations, but let me give you a quick example of what I'm talking about when I say that. The I key is the most obvious and simple way to enter insert mode, and probably the one you'll use the most, as it enters insert mode and leaves your cursor where it was. But you can also enter insert mode as well as move your cursor to the end of the line by hitting Shift A, for example, or uppercase A if you prefer. Or you can enter insert mode on a new line under your current cursor position by hitting O. No matter what command you use to enter insert mode, you'll always be able to exit back to normal mode by again using the escape key. Now that we've found our ability to write code again, let's dive into what you can do in normal mode to move around that code. The basics of your movement will be done using the H, J, K, and L keys. H to go left one character, L to go right one character, J to go down one character, and K to go up one character. Basically emulating the arrow keys you are probably used to using, but while keeping your hands on the home row of your keyboard. Don't worry, this will become second nature very quickly. And although it's probably some of the keys you'll end up using the most as you're working, they're definitely not suitable for all your navigation. Moving character by character or line by line through a whole file can be a bit slow. You have plenty of options to move around in bigger chunks while using Vim, but here's a couple to get you started. First, you can move to the next word by using W. Or move back one word by using B. You can also move to the end of a line by using the dollar sign key, and to the beginning of a line by using the zero key. For big vertical leaps, you can move half a page up by using Ctrl U, and half a page down by using Ctrl D. This should cover many of the basic commands you'll use to move around, and is plenty enough to get you started and used to the core flow of navigating in Vim. But there's one more thing that I want to show you that will be extremely easy to demonstrate using these navigation commands we just talked about. There's many commands in Vim that are actually repeatable. For example, if I want to go down 10 lines, instead of hitting the J key 10 times, I can actually type 10, then J, and it will repeat the J command 10 times. Or if I want to move right 7 characters, I could type 7 and then L to achieve that. It's not always the most useful for navigation purposes, but it's still something to keep in mind as it can be used with many useful commands. Now that we are able to move around our code, we can learn about how to edit that code, or how to copy, paste, and delete parts of it. The four base commands you'll need to learn for that are Y to yank, or what we usually call copy, P to paste, D to delete, and C to change, but we'll get back to that last one in a second. That's nice, but you might be a little bit confused right now. How do I decide what I delete or what I copy before using those commands? Let's introduce the last basic mode you'll need to use while learning Vim, the visual mode, or what basically is the selection tool, if you will. While in normal mode, press V and you'll enter visual mode, like Xcode shows you. Now, using the same navigation keys that are used to move around in normal mode, you navigate around your code and everything between your cursor position and the initial initial position it was in when you entered visual mode will be highlighted. With your selection highlighted, you can use the copy or delete commands to do what you'd expect them to do. You can use the paste command to replace your selection with the content of your clipboard, or you can use the change command, which will delete the content of your selection and directly put you into insert mode so you can add more text. So there you have it. With this handful of commands, you'll have everything you need to start learning the basics of Vim. You know how to move around your code using the navigation commands, how to enter insert mode so you can type in new code. You can enter visual mode to select parts of your code using those same navigation commands and move things around or delete them as you need. It won't be the most efficient way or the fastest way of using Vim, but we'll get you accustomed to the basics you'll always need and you'll always be using. There's plenty more commands to share with you that will speed up your editing while using Vim. But if you've never used it before and trying it out in Xcode 13 as the first encounter you have with Vim, I suggest you spend a bit of time trying to learn these basic commands first. Once you're a bit more comfortable and have a feel for how to work in Vim, you can go back to those cheat sheets or any other resources to try to incorporate new and more specific commands to speed up your workflow. For example, how to copy a full line using a single command, or how to delete the content between two parentheses without entering visual mode, how to delete a single character without visual mode, or how to change the capitalization of a character without entering insert mode. Add on new commands bit by bit as you get used to them and as you need them, and build up that toolbox. Anyway, I hope you found this interesting or useful. I try to limit myself to the very basics so people that are intrigued with Vim and Xcode 13 have a straightforward starting point. Hopefully I hit that mark. If you enjoyed this video, please consider liking it and hitting the subscribe button for more iOS related content, whether it's tutorials, development vlogs, or Xcode tips like this one. I also have a Patreon page that you can check out if you would like to support the work I do on here and help me increase the quality and quantity of content I share. Again, I hope this was useful. I'll see you all in the next video, and until then, take care.
And I almost forgot, the U key undoes. You're probably gonna need that a lot.